Ever wanted to run Ubuntu 20.04 alongside a Windows 10 machine? Well, you can using Windows Subsystem for Linux. Let me show you how to enable it. So the first step is to enable the subsystem. To enable the subsystem, you want to go to the search bar and type in turn Windows features on or off. And you should see this match right here. And you want to go ahead and click on it. It's going to open up this small window, and you want to scroll down until you find Windows Subsystem for Linux. So when you see that, you want to go ahead and click on the box and hit OK. And it's going to say searching for required files, and it's going to say applying changes. Now, to get this to effect, you need to go ahead and restart your computer. So I want to go ahead and restart my computer. So now that you have the subsystem installed, you want to go ahead and find a Linux distro. To find a Linux distro, you want to go to the Windows Store. It'll load up. And then you want to search up Linux. And over here, you have a variety of distros. You have Ubuntu, Kali Linux, Debian, stuff like that. The one I want to get is the Ubuntu 20.04 LTS, but you can get any other you want. I'm going to go ahead and install. So, should start installing. After you've installed your Linux distro of choice, you want to go ahead and launch the app. Now it's going to say installing, this may take a few minutes. And it will take a few minutes. On older systems or slower systems, it may take a bit longer than a few minutes, but it will work. So now it's going to say please create a default Unix user account. Username does not need to match your Windows username. And my username is going to put realtechnerd. And for my password, it's going to be secret. It's going to be a secret. And enter. So there we have it, guys. Ubuntu 20.04 running on Windows 10. This doesn't lag my computer. It runs perfectly fine. I can use Linux commands like lscpu. So it works amazing. So guys, you're not just limited to these type of commands. You can also use stuff like the apt-get command. Although notice that you're gonna have to use a PPA to download apps, because this does not have like a software center built in, because it's so stripped down and stuff. So you're gonna have to use a PPA to download commands. Anyways, guys, thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, tell me in the comments on how we can improve in the next video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!